Hi, Kevin from Snowy's Outdoors here. Today I'm going to show you how to set up and pack away the Zempire Pronto 4 air tent. So this is easy to erect. It comes with air poles that includes its own pump and can be erected by one person. Now the tent comes in a really handy carry bag. It's got some good handles on it and some tensioning straps. It weighs 13.7 kilos and the dimensions are 72 centimeters long by approximately 36 by 36 centimeters in dimensions. Now we'll have a look what's inside. So this is what you get with the tent. Now over here you've got the drawstring bag, quite a durable bag. You can see it's got an expandable section on the side so that if you need to, can't get the tent rolled up quite tightly, it can still fit in the bag okay. This is of course your tent with a couple of tie straps that go all the way around to tying it up. You've got awning poles over here that are for the awning. They come in your own bag. Tent pegs and guy ropes, as well as the pump, both of those in their own bag. Now with the pump, when you set it up, the first thing you do is you put the pressure relief valve on here first, and then you fit the pressure gauge onto it after that. Then you are able to connect the hose that gets attached to your tent, and that's what you pump it up with. Okay, now when you're assembling this tent, there are instructions inside the bag. They're actually sewn in, so you can't lose them, which is a really good idea. You can pull them out, but good idea to leave them in the pocket. Right, so now let's unroll it, and we start assembling the tent. Right, so pull that out. Now it's important to get the orientation of your tent, work out where the front is so you know which way it sits. So this is the front. You can see there is a couple of eyelets there. That's where the tent poles go in for your awning. There's one there, one down here on the other corner. Now I want the tent to face in that direction, so I'm just going to turn it around. And now I'll just peg out the base. So this is the eyelet. You need to put your peg into here. Just make sure that the tent is out nice and tight. Go down. You do all four corners first. Okay, we'll get the pump. You can see at the front of this, well, just exactly the side, this is called a Boston valve. Now the Boston valve is in two pieces. See that little flap there? That's your valve. And that is what you use to evacuate the air when you're disassembling the tent. But to pump it up, make sure that's screwed in nice and tight. You take off the top cap, and this is what you put your pump on. Okay, the last few screws, get that on. Now there's one valve on this end, and there's another valve on the other end of the tent. So we're all set up, now let's start pumping. See, it's starting to fill the sleeves up. A bit of exercise doing this. And just while I'm doing that, I'll just point something out. This has a choice. You can either have this as a double action pump. You switch that around, you have a single action pump. What that means is that the pump is pumping on one stroke. You can hear it is sucking air in on the upstroke and pumping it out on the downstroke. Goes back to double action. I'm actually sucking and pumping on both strokes. So it gives you a little bit more speed. Anyway, we'll keep going. Once it gets a bit tight, just stop what you're doing. Just help the tent get up into the erected position. See, it's already creating its shape. And then keep pumping it, add some more air to it. You see, we're almost at 7 psi, which is what they recommend. Okay, that's 7 psi. That's enough air in the bladders. Can we take the hose off here? Careful not to loosen that Boston valve, because you will lose all the air you've just put in. And put your cap on nice and tight. So as you can see, there's lots of pegs around the base. I'm just going to show you how to do a couple. This peg fits into the corner like so and helps hold it down. And of course we're also one in the center of the tent. Now these pegs are on all corners, on all sides, and when you're camping you should always put them all in. Don't cheat and think it's not going to bother. Get them all in, holds the tent down properly. Now on each corner there is a guy rope. In the center there is a guy rope as well. These also need to be put down. We're not going to bother with that today. It's not very windy. We're just showing you how it gets assembled. But if you're out camping, it's essential you put down all the guy ropes, all the tent pegs, because if you do happen to get a gust of wind, it's not going to hold your tent down. It's just going to take off. What I will show you, however, is how the awning gets put up. Now, the awning has two poles to come with it. They're a three-piece pole. That's what they look like when they're assembled. It's a good idea to assemble them first. You have a centerpiece goes into the top. Top is obvious, you've got a little spike up there. And the bottom pole goes in there. And just put them either side of your tent so they're ready. Okay, now with the guy ropes, there's two long guy ropes and two short guy ropes. The two long guy ropes is what goes on the poles. And these two shorter ones, which will go on the side of the awning, which I'll show you later. Now, just a good idea to do this first is to put a loop on each end of the guy ropes. You can do a bowline if you want to, or just do a simple knot like that. That's what go over the pole. So over here, we've got a zipper. Some Velcro tabs. All the way up. And of course this end, we do the same. Now, this is where you grab your pole. Pop it in the little metal eyelet we showed you earlier. Now you can put your guy rope over the top of the pole like this if you want to, or you can simply slip it through here and tie it off if you want to. Just for this exercise, I'm going to put it on top of the pole. On the end of the guy rope, there is a little pull. That's the part that goes down your tent peg. So just pull that through a little bit. And you pull it out so it's at a nice 45 degree angle. Put your peg in your loop. Pull it out, shove it in the ground. It's nice and soft, I don't really need a mallet. And you pull your tent peg pole tight. And then you do the same with the other side. Okay, so we've got our peg. And push it into the ground. You can use these slides to tension your rope, make it nice and tight. Now on this side, this is where you actually can tie it down. With your guy rope, this is the short guy rope, I'm going to tie this on here permanently. Couple of loops, and this is what I'm going to peg down. See that straps out the way down here. So you sort of judge it so that you're pulling it in a nice neat angle. Can let it go a bit longer if you want to, and once again straight into the ground. Luckily it's soft ground once again. And that's the side turned down, and now we're going to do the other side. Now over this side we can tie it down the same, or if you want to, you can roll it up. You can see there's this little T-block there and another one there. That means you can actually roll this awning up here, or the side of the awning. Pop it over there, you've got a loop. That T-piece goes through and it holds it off nicely. Got another one just here. And you can leave it up like that if you want to, or you can have it tied down like it is on the other side. Now the last thing we need to do is at the back here, you've got this little flap. This can get pulled out. You can see it gives you a little bit more air, allows the air to get underneath the tent and a bit of airflow. This gets pegged in the same as all the others. You've got an adjustment on there if you want to. And of course you've got your guy rope here. Once again, you can pull it in. Now just go around this side here. I just want to reiterate that you need to have all the pegs in the tent, all the guy ropes tied down. That's what makes it secure. And as always, my recommendation is to put a ground sheet underneath your tent. Ground sheet only needs to be a tarp or something you buy from the hardware store. The idea of the ground sheet is to protect the floor from anything sharp from cutting through it. It's not a waterproofing layer. The floor is already waterproof. You just need to protect it from anything sharp. So now I'm going to show you how the whole tent is dismantled. Now it's very important that everything gets zipped up first, all of the windows and doors, which I'll do now. Now just one thing you note, you don't have to zip it all the way up because you do have to let air come out of the tent when it goes down. So from there we go onto the awning. You can actually leave these ones tied on if you want to, but I'm just taking them off. And then we zip this up the front, all the way down. Now at this point, all of your guy ropes need to be taken out, as well as the other tent pegs, but leave the four in the corner till the last minute. Now we come around here, we'll undo the Boston valves. You hear the air coming out already. And down she goes. allow it to completely deflate. And once it's down, then you can take out your corner pegs. It's also a good idea to undo both the valves. Even though it came down with one, this allows all of the air to escape the tubes quite comfortably. Then it's just a matter of rolling it into a nice rectangular shape. It should fly over into the center of the tent. Now, a good idea is to get your bag. The tent has to fold up into that length. So if we lay the bag just on the valve side of the tent, this allows the air to escape when you fold it up. Just fold half over and do the same to this side. And then we fold that half over the top again. Now you can see, if you look at the bag and look at the tent, I've got it pretty much the right length to go into the bag. And starting from opposite the valve side, start to roll. Squash as we go, get all of the air out of the valve, out of the air holes, and out of the tent as well. I just stick my knee on it sometimes to squash out the last of the air. You can see it's going down nice and flat. Now there are a couple of straps just over here. This is a double ring. Put this right around the tent on one end. Just pull it over the top. There we go. Now, remember there were some few other bits that went in here. There's something I've always found. When you buy a tent and you unwrap it from its box, it's all nice and neat. But it doesn't always go back exactly how you want it to. And that's just the nature of the way they pack it in the factory. The advantage of this bag is you have this expandable section here, you can see. So it actually expands and allows you to get those things back in nice and safe and secure. So I'll do up these D-rings again. So I've almost got it back to its original shape. So that's it for the erecting and dismantling of the Pronto 4 air tent from Zempire. Now, if you want any more information on this tent or any other products we have, go to our website, snowys.com.au, where we have the lowest prices every day. So if you want to subscribe, click up here. If you want to watch any more videos, click over here. And if you want to ask a question, leave a comment down below.